Hello friends, our next topic of discussion is JK flip-flop, its truth table, excitation table and timing diagram. So let us first understand the diagram of JK flip-flop, which is level triggered. In this case, the flip-flop input clock that we are using is not edge triggered, rather it is level triggered. Whenever logic high is coming at the clock, then and only then this circuit is working. Otherwise, this is not working. With edge, this circuit does not trigger. This is level triggered circuit. Then let's understand this circuit. This is consisting of all NAND gates. And NAND, we understand that NAND is triggered by 0 input, not triggered by 1 input. This is because, let us say, we have multi-input NAND gate. If all inputs are 1, output is going to be 0. But even if single input goes to binary 0, output has to go binary 1. So this circuit is triggered by binary 0, not triggered by binary 1. It changes its output state to high whenever any 1-0 comes onto input side of a NAND gate. So NAND circuit is always triggered by binary 0, not triggered by binary 1. So this is the concept that we'll be using to solve this circuit diagram. Now this is our truth table indicating functionality of JK flip-flop. So whenever J and K both are 0 0, Qn, this is the previous state we have taken, next state we want to find out. We know the circuit diagram, truth table we want to find out, excitation table we want to find out, and timing diagram we wanted to find out. So this is learning outcome of this class, that we learn how to create this, this and this. So let's say J, K and Qn all are 0, 0, 0. So this is previous state, this is our next state, this is J, K input, clock is level triggered. So because we have Qn is equal to 0, Qn bar will be equal to 1. J, K both are 0, 0, 0 and 0. And now Qn bar is equal to 1, Qn will be equal to 0. So at the input of this, let us say clock is equal to 1. So this is first clock which is come, which is equal to 1. Now this is 1, this is 0, this is 1. At the input of NAND gate, even if single input goes to 0, output will be equal to 1. 0, 0, 1. So single input goes to 0, output will be 1. Now what happens? Here it is 1, here it is 1. So output will not change, because what is the previous state? Previous state value here is 1. Here it is 0. So this 0 will be coming onto this side. So this will make this next state as 1. And this will be 0. So previous state and next state are same, and hence output does not change. If it is 0, next state will also be 0. Now let us take second input. Second case, 0, 0, 1. J is equal to 0, K is equal to 0, Qn is equal to 1, so Qn bar will be equal to 0. Now this Qn is equal to 1, so this will be equal to 1, this is equal to 0, so this will be equal to 0. Okay, now 0, 0, 1, any input goes to 0, output will be 1. Any input goes to 0, 1, 1, 0, this will be 1. Now, because this is 0, so this will go up, 0 dot 1 will be 1 here, because this is 1, so this will be 0, right? Now, previous state is 1, next state is also 1. So, output does not change when J and K both are 0, 0. Now take third part. Zero, 1, 0, J is equal to 0, K is equal to 1, Qn is equal to 0, so Qn bar will be equal to 1. Now, putting all these values into this circuit, Qn bar is equal to 1, Qn will be equal to 0, 0, 1, 1. So, any input goes to 0, output will be 1, 1, 0, 1. So, this will be 1 when both legs are carrying 1, 1, output will not change. This is what we experienced in these two sets of inputs. And hence it will stay at 0 and this will stay at 1. So output will be 0. Now second case is 0, 1, 1. If Qn goes to 1, then Qn bar will go to 0, Qn bar will go to 0 and this will become 1. Now note that this is 1, this is 1, this is also 1, so this will be 0. So this is the first time we are encountering 0 here, and any input 0, so this will be 1. Now question comes, which leg to be processed first, upper leg or lower leg? Now the leg which is carrying 0 will be processed first because NAND is activated by 0. So whenever there is a 0, it is to be processed first. This is the principle. Then if this is 0, this will be 1. And if this is 1, this will be 0. So next state output will be 0. Got it? Now next part. Erase all the values. Okay, then 100. 10. This is 0. This is 1. If this is 0, this will be 1 and this will be 0. Now this 0, 0, 1. This will be 1. 1, 1, 1, this will be 0. Which leg will be processed first? Upper leg, because this contains 0. If any input on this side will go to 0, this will become 1. If this is 1, this will be 0. And hence next state will be binary 1. Now next we'll take this value. 1, 0 will remain the same. Present state value is 1. So this is 1, this is 0. Qn is equal to 1, Qn bar is equal to 0. Now 0, 1, 1. This will be, any input goes to 0, output will be 1. 1, 0, 1. 1, 0, 1. So any input goes to 0, output will be 1. That means output will not change. As and when there is binary 1, output never changes. If this is 0, 0 coming here, this will be 1 and this is already 1. So this is 1, this is 0, output will not change. So binary 1. Now come over to the last two sets of inputs. This is 1, 1. Present state is 0. Present state is 0. Present state bar is equal to 1. So 0 will be coming here, 1 will be coming here. Now 1, 1, 1. This will be 0. 1, 1, 0. This will be 1. Which leg will process first? Upper leg or lower leg? Upper leg. Now, because this has 0, so 0, this will be 1 and this will be 0. So this will become 1. And similarly, if it has 0 and this has 1, then because this one and this one, so again this will be inverted, 1 will be inverted to 0. And this 1 will go to 0. Now we can also create the timing diagram. When 0, 0, k, j and k both are 0, 0, so q1 plus 1 will be same as that of previous. 0, 0, then this will also be same as that of previous. So this will be qn only. Qn plus 1 will be qn only. Or what we can do is we can write this as qn, and below there will be another line that will be indicating qn plus 1. So if this is 0, then this will also be 0. 0, 0, 1, then this will also be 1, like this. Right. Now 0, 1, 0. So this is 0, this is 1, 0, 1. Next is 0, 1. So this is 0, this is 1. Now next state will be 0, 0 in both the cases. 0, 0 in both the cases. Then 1, 0, j is 1 and this is 0. 1, 1, 0, 0. Next is 0, 1. 0, 1. So what will be the next state? It will be 0, 0. So it will be 0. First set, second set, third set, first set, second set, third set. So 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, it will be 1, 1. This will be 1, this will be 1. Right? And then last set, 1, 1. J and K both are 1, 1. When both are 1, 1, then this is 0 and this is 1. Then output will toggle. Output will toggle mean if it is 0, then it will be 1, otherwise this will be 0. Now, using this truth table, we can create a excitation table. Excitation table says for what set of output change this JK changes are bringing what changes in the output, or output changes set is given, what changes are bringing this output change set in on the input side. So what changes on the output side are bringing input side changes. Let us say Q1, Q1 plus 1 is taken as 0, 0. So this set is 0, 0 and 0, 0. For this particular set, JK 0, 0, this is 0, 0. And this is 0, 1. So this is 0 fixed, this is not fixed. So this is 0, this is don't care. So JK will be 0, don't care. Right? So whatever be the value of K, if J is 0, output will not change. The next is 0, 1. 0, 1 case is 0, 1 case is this. And 0, 1 case is this. So this is indicating 1, 0, 1, 1. So this is 1, 0 and this is 1, 1. So this is 1 as it is and this is don't care, 1 don't care. So this is 1 don't care. The next is 0, 1. 0, 1 means 0, 1 we have done. Next is 1, 0. 1, 0. So 1, 0 is this and last one for this set and this set. So 0, 1, 1, 1. So this is 0, this is 1 and next is 1, 1. So this is 1 and this is don't care 1. So So don't care 1. The next is 1 1. So 1 1 case is this, and another case is this. So it is changing 0 0 1 0. 0 0 0 1 0. J K. So K is staying at 0. K is staying at 0, and J is don't care. So this is our excitation table. In the next class, we'll talk of race around condition in JK flip-flop.